What is linguistics and how linguistics is a scientific study? Hello viewers, today we are going to discuss about what is linguistics and how linguistics is a scientific study. If you want to get the notes of this lecture, you may have the link in the description. Before starting my lecture, I would like to ask people to subscribe my channel, to click on the bell icon, like this video, and don't forget to post your feedback in the comment section. Thank you so much. In the recent years, one of the fastest expanding branches of the knowledge has been linguistics. Linguistics is the scientific study of a language. It is not a study of a particular language. Linguistics try to answer some of the questions like what is language, how does language work, what kind of variation is found among the languages, how does human language differ from the language of animals, how does children speak language and why do language change? What is the relationship between language and culture? Linguistics is the scientific study of language. This is really the simplest definition of the linguistics, but it contains more important words. For example, when we say that linguistics is a scientific study, it doesn't mean that when we are going to do linguistics, we need lab coats and safety gloves to do linguistics. Linguistics conduct formal studies of speech sounds and grammatical structure and the meanings of the languages all over the world, around about 6,000 languages. They also investigate that how language is being acquired by the infants and how language is being delivered, how the language is being perceived, what is the difference between the written language and spoken language, what is the connection or what is the relationship between the language and the culture, and also with the neural system and the neural structure that enables us to use the language in the society or in the field of languages. Personal likeness, personal dislikeness. Subjectivity and objectivity doesn't matter in the field of linguistics. You have to follow all the rules and the regulation of the language in the field of linguistics. But on the other hand, in the field of literature, you may be biased. You can use your personal likeness, personal dislikeness, and you can justify your statements too. But in the field of language, you doesn't have the right to use your personal likeness and dislikeness. For an example, if I want to say that 2 plus 2 is equal to 5, how I can say that? 2 plus 2 is equal to 4, it is 4 in the field of linguistics, but in the field of literature, you may prove it 2 plus 2 is equal to 5. It's up to you. You may use your personal likeness and dislikeness in the field of literature, but not in the field of linguistics. The scientific way of thinking about the language involves making systematic empirical observation. There is another important word. Empirical means that we observe the data to find the evidence for our theories. All the scientists that make empirical observation, for an example, botanists observe that how plants grow and how plants reproduce. Chemists observe that how substances interact with each other. Linguists observe that how language is used. A crucial thing to keep in mind is that the observation that we make about the language, the observation that we make about the language use are not the value judgments. Lots of people in the world, for an example, like your high school teacher, various newspapers, columnists, maybe your grandparents, and maybe even some of your fellows make the judgments about the languages, but not a linguist makes a judgment about the language. Linguistics is a descriptive study. Descriptive means to describe something or description of something. Linguists are interested in what is said, not what to be said or what ought to be said. They described and observed the language in all the aspects and facts. Descriptive description is based on an observation. We can describe things, we can describe something after observation. As you notice the things as they are, we have to describe the thing as we have noticed. There are the plenty of the species who are just communicating to each other. They just want to communicate each other. They are just delivering their messages, their codes, their piece of information to each other in a really impressive way. But in the field of linguistics, we are just mainly concerned with the speech system of the human language. It turns out that the human has some important differences to all other species that make our language really unique. The three systems are there. The first one system is articulatory phonetics. The second one is auditory phonetics. And the third one is neural phonetics. That is really related to our mind. The articulatory phonetics. First, what we call articulatory phonetics are lungs, larynx, pharynx, vocal cords, our tongue, the shape that our tongue makes, lips, nose, that enables us to produce the language speech sounds. No other species can do like this. They are not using their tongue, nose, larynx, pharynx. All these vocal cords are involved in the production of speech sound. They are just producing the speech sound and we are just using the languages. Second system is auditory system that really help us to perceive the languages, that really help us to listen to languages. Our ears are sensitive to exactly the frequencies that are most common in human speech. There are many species that have the similar pattern of the auditory system, but humans, newborn babies, pay special attention to the human speech sounds. The most important of all the human language system is neural system. It is really related to the neural linguistics. Neural linguistics means the study of language with respect to the brain. Our brain really helps us to learn the languages, to produce the languages, to understand the messages, to understand the piece of information that has been delivered to us. For example, if I want to convey a message to my friend, the message has just been created or generated in my mind. It is really, it has been saved in my mind. Whenever I want to convey, it will just come, my brain will just process it to my tongue. Or whenever it comes on my tongue, it will be in the linguistic format. It will be called a linguistic form of messages. It means that it has been created with respect to our mind. And whenever I am going to receive a message by someone, whenever I am going to receive a piece of information that has come into my ear, the auditory system will convert this message into a code format that our mind will interpret it accordingly.